the Kauffman Memorial Garden. We're the first garden in Kauffman Legacy Park to open. And it's about a 2-acre garden within the stone wall and wrought iron fence, influenced by Mr. and Mrs. Kauffman's travels. They traveled a lot in their later years, and Mrs. Kauffman always wished that there was a more formal garden in the middle part of the city for people to go visit, often as you would see in other large communities and cities abroad. This is the Allée. It's got the two upper hedges on the top and hydrangeas underneath. We've just planted our mum rotation for the fall. We will be planting the rest of our mums next week. Our annual beds here, we rotate them 4 times a year. Now, we do have a bunch of sculptures in our garden that are done by Tom Corbin, the local artist, along with 6 fountains in the garden. So it's got water and flowers and structure. It's got an orangery that is remnants of 12th and 13th century French. And we also have 16 gardenia plants that bloom in the spring because they were Mrs. Kauffman's favorite flowers. This is the second area of the garden here, and we call it the green garden because it is the only area in the garden with grass that I have to take care of. It's got this octagonal pool and perennials in the upper beds. Now in the garden, there are over 478 different varieties of perennial plant materials so that you can come through the garden and see something in the perennial beds in bloom at all times. This is the largest area of the garden here. We call it the canal. It's got 3 dancing girls, again, by Tom Corbin. The canal is actually 80 foot long and 12 foot wide. And from the boxwood hedges into the middle is pretty much mirror imaged. And those are all annual beds. So those should be pretty full and floriferous all year long. However, in the winter, when things aren't happening outside, that's when all the fun starts in the orangery. Not only do we take in all the citrus trees and all the gardenias and stuff inside the orangery before the first hard freeze in the fall, but we come in with 800 poinsettias and decorations for the holiday seasons. Here at the garden, we don't use any herbicides or insecticides in our bed. We also don't deadhead our coneflowers, and that's why they look like that, because if you're here in the morning, when the sun's starting to rise, you'll see tons of goldfinches feeding on those, just chirping away and having a gay old time. Make sure to go behind the building. On all the walls, we try to grow things or espalier things on them just so that everything's not on one surface. It actually draws your eye up into the sky to see more color and more excitement all the way surrounding you and rather than just at your feet. We have this now due to Mr. and Mrs. Kauffman's philanthropic funding and a lot of other things in Kansas City with their name on it. And this is open every single day of the year to the public at no charge.
This work and research was funded by the Ewing Marion Kauffman Foundation. The contents of this publication are solely the responsibility of the grantee.